What's up, bodybuilding sports fans and muscle meds enthusiasts? It's me, Kai Greene here, aka Mr. Getting It Done. And I'm here in the gym at night working to create something beautiful. Are you taking your amino decanate? I am. Anyway, just wanted to take a minute and reach out to you people at home. If you're watching this on the internet, just wanted to say what's up. And thank you for all the wonderful kind of support and love that I've been able to feel when traveling lately. We've been to everywhere. Just a lot of places, too many places to mention at one time. But while I have you here, I just wanted to take a minute and say hello, send some positive energy, and it's the holiday season, and this is a time when a lot of families and people are getting together, you know, thankful, expressing their gratitude to the universe and their creator for, you know, life, family, and having a very prosperous and successful year. I know, though, personally, having been not a very happy person for a very, very long time, being very angry and very upset and kind of locked away in my own sadness and being very resentful of that, holiday time was a very difficult time for me. And if you are a person that was very much like me at another time in my life, the holiday time might present a lot of reason for emotional despair. And if so, I just wanted to take a minute and throw this at you because it's been very, very, very helpful for me. And that is to recognize that this doesn't have to be a very difficult time for you emotionally. You know, I believe that, you know, you can make a choice about your own success or failure. And I believe that it is up to you, or in this case, it was definitely up to me, to make some really good decisions about how I could choose to spend this time of the year. I had one option of turning around and being angry and locking myself in this place of despair, you know, cut off my resources and be that miser Ebenezer Scrooge type of person, you know, or, you know, can make another decision, and that is to be a part of your own healing process. You know, this doesn't have to be a very difficult time of the year. You don't have to lock yourself away and hold yourself hostage to the failures of the past. I believe it's my personal responsibility to try to heal, to commit myself to healing. And, you know, without trying to throw a bunch of rhetoric and jargon at you, I'm just going to tell you that if you are like me and if you are looking for a better way to experience this and don't want to go through your own commitment to the negative thoughts and feelings of emotional despair, I encourage you to go out there and make a different choice. Don't commit to that. Go out there and do something. Share a meal with someone. Do a kind deed, you know, try to give a little bit more of yourself. Make the choice not to be locked away in this place of emotional despair. Put a smile on your face and try to put a smile on someone else's. Even if it's fake, you might find that if you try the spirit will try you. So I guess in short, what I'm saying is I challenge you to commit yourself to your own healing. Think of something that will be positive and fruitful, and give somebody an opportunity to experience joy. You know, buy a cup of coffee for somebody. You know, tell a story, listen to a story. Try to give the best that you have to offer to someone that you see that's not doing as well as you are. And the possibility will exist that you may actually heal yourself by trying to help someone else. So, in short, the takeaway is you have an option, and the option is to aim to heal yourself.